Hello guys, welcome back to HS World. Today I am going to explain about safety inspection. After watching this video, I do hope that the topic of safety inspection would be clear. Please do like, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon. Never miss an update on safety management. Let us see what is the safety inspection. A safety inspection is a formalized and properly documented process of identifying hazards in the workplace. Safety inspection involves a checklist which helps to assess each area or potential hazards at workplace. So, first of all, we are going to see the definition of safety inspection. Safety inspection, as defined by PS 3811 1964, inspection is the process of ensuring by assessment that a facility reaches the necessary standards of quality or performance and that the level is maintained. So, as per the British standards, inspection is the process of ensuring by assessment that a facility means any organization or any workplace reaches the necessary standards, means it's maintain the necessary requirement of the safety or standards. So let us see the next definition. Safety inspection. So safety inspection is defined as that monitoring function conducted in an organization to locate and report existing and potential hazards which have the capacity to cause accident in the workplace. So the safety inspection means to identify or to ensure the hazards existed in the workplace. Let us see safety and health inspection. Safety and health inspection ensure that working condition, environment and action methods conform to legal or safety requirement and combined effort of employers, employee, safety expert and inspectors to create a safe working environment. Means a safety and health inspection ensure the working condition and the environment and action conform to legal or safety requirement. Means at the workplace, what type of the safety requirement is needed. In the next, we are going to have a look over objectives of inspection. So what is the objectives of inspection? To find out hazards, accident causes, unsafe conditions and unsafe actions, losses and appropriate remedial measures for their preventive and control. So the objective of the inspection is to find out hazard, accident causes, losses and also the remedial, means the control measures to prevent and control the hazards and control the accidents at workplace. To maintain safe work environment, operational profitability and control unsafe actions of worker. In the next we'll see the objectives of inspection. To check statutory provisions of the Factory Act and similar other safety statutes. To check the effectiveness of the existing system and to find improvement if required for the purpose of total loss control. It is called TLC, total loss control. In the next we'll see objective of inspection. To check quality control, product safety, GMP, good manufacturing practice, wear and tear, corrosion, test and also personal selection. To gain workers' confidence in organized human activity and factory life. In the next we'll focus type of inspection. Inspection can be classified in many ways and explained below. The first one is planned inspection. The second one is continuous inspection. The third one is statutory inspection. So Now we are going to cover each inspection. First we'll cover the plant inspection. There are 4 types of inspection in the plant inspection. So what is the first? Periodic inspection. Second, intermittent inspection. Third, general inspection. Fourth, special inspection. So in the next we are going to focus one by one: periodic, intermittent, general and special inspection. Periodic inspection. Plant, machinery, equipment, lifting machines, pressure vessels, procedures, methods and health of the worker should be examined at regular pre-plant period. Safety committee, safety officer, competent person, safety consultant, industrial hygienist, other safety and health professional should carry out such inspection. In the next we'll see intermittent inspection. What is the intermittent inspection? It is carried out at irregular intervals to check new equipment installations, procedures and workers, modifications, accident analysis, etc. Some partial inspections are also carried out at uncertain interval. So which inspection is being carried out at uncertain interval? That is called intermittent inspection. In the next we'll see general inspection. So it is general or routine inspection to check places which are not covered by other inspection, such as isolated area, parking places, sidewalks, fencing, light, illumination, reporting after long shutdown, etc. are checked by such general or overhead inspection. In the next, we'll discuss about the special inspection. Safety or hazard analysis, accident investigation, checking of dangerous operation or vessel, building safety, subject of complaint only. Inspection during a special complaints and new installations and only for storage, processes, methods, hand tools, scaffolds, guards, facilities, protective equipment, etc. fall within this category. In the next, we'll focus on continuous inspection. This is part B. Part 1 was plant inspection. Now we are going to discuss on part B, continuous inspection. Some personnel like safety officer, maintenance man, electrician, etc. spend their all time in observing certain equipment, vessel, processes, operations, safety devices, personal protective equipment, etc. to maintain them in a safe and efficient working condition. So this is the continuous inspection. Means in the one shift, one electrician is moving around the electrical panels and the electrical operated equipments to check and to ensure the safety of the equipment panel. So that is the continuous monitoring. So it is called continuous inspection system. Thus, continuous watch and familiarity with the employees, equipment, machines and environment are maintained as a part of informal and cooperative responsibility. So this is the continuous inspection. Now we are going to see what is the statutory inspection. So this is part C, statutory inspection. This is carried out by factory inspector and other authorities under various safety statutes to check the implementation of statutory provisions. A strict and timely compliance of statutory provisions are necessary. Breach of safety law and standards may attract prosecution. So the statutory inspection is being carried out by the government factory inspector. So this is called statutory inspection. For most of the factories where there is no system of internal inspection, statutory means government inspection is the only effective inspection, and therefore it should be carried out in detail, and the government must employ sufficient staff to achieve better safety inspection. and the better safety standard in the organization or in the industries. I hope this topic is clear, and thanking you for watching this video. Please do like and subscribe my channel for upcoming new video on safety management.